Time to get down to the business news with Nona Peltier. Nona, interesting developments with the media company NZME. So the chair of the board is gone, resigned or something else?
I think it's a kind of a mix. He just basically resigned prior to a protest vote, which was going to vote him off. So take that as you will. But in the end, it was this morning, the chair of NZME, Peter Cullinane, felt that he was probably, you know, it was more reasonable for him to step down ahead of the meeting that they were holding. And then just before the annual meeting was held this afternoon at 3 p.m., the company released a statement saying that he had stepped down. No explanation was offered. But the message from the directors still on the board was that they did have confidence in the company's chief executive, Michael Boggs. So whatever happened around that board table, we're not exactly 100% sure. But we did get to speak to Mr. Cullinane just a few moments ago. And this is what he had to say.
The fact of the matter is there was a group of Australian fund managers who, you know, were looking to, you know, signal a protest vote, and I was up for, you know, re-election by rotation, and so I was the lucky recipient of that protest vote.
Yes, and so why they were going to vote him off is still a question that wasn't answered by Mr. Cullinane. However, there was some questions raised at the meeting. For example, one of them was, how much did the company spend on their legal fees in their attempt to buy stuff? And the answer there was $1.8 million. So there was probably some other issues around that board table they were talking about, and just some of the strategies perhaps that the company had pursued in the last year.
So who gets to slide into his seat then?
Not known at this stage. The board is going to meet over the next week to see who will be the new chair. So for now, Mr. Cullinane is off the board.
What is the deal with consumer spending? I mean, it's skyrocketed, you're telling me, since last month. Are we all, everybody pent up, wanted to go out and spend some money?
That's probably it. So the seasonally adjusted numbers, and this is for electronic card spending, so that's not total retail sales. So Statistics New Zealand said that the seasonally adjusted numbers there were 68.9% increase. Now, that was after lows in April, mind you. Never mind, though, people did spend a total of $5.3 billion on their cards last month. And you'd be surprised, what they were buying was mostly furniture and hardware. I guess these were things they weren't able to buy during the level four lockdown.
Yeah.
So they were buying, you know, we heard about how they were spending money on their shopping, groceries and so on. But as soon as they had a chance to go out and really spend some money, they did.
I'd be interested what percentage of that is the total spend, because I bet you most people were using cards because of hygiene reasons and all the rest of it as well.
Could be that as well. It's going to be interesting to see, because we have so many odd numbers that have come through in May because just the difference. And we've been looking at these and trying to make sense of them. And when you talk to analysts, they just say, we really can't tell if this is a trend or what's going to happen next. Certainly, though, the U.S. Federal Reserve came out early today, overnight really, in the United States, with some pretty grim news about the economic outlook in the United States. And that certainly put a damper on the markets here today and in Australia. So our top 50 index, it fell almost 1%. 106 points down to still, though, 11,155, which is still a pretty high number. The ASX, though, was down nearly 3% just a little while ago. The New Zealand dollar slipped slightly, 64.9 US cents, 93.6 cents Australian, which is slightly up, and 51.2 British pence, which has hardly changed.
Thanks, Nona. Nona Peltier with our business news.